Flux Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, we finish off making the probe for the electronic edge finder by soldering the ball onto the top. And we also assemble the probe body and the electrics inside and test it. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it.
First of all, I'm going to put some flux. This is electrical flux. So I've put some solder on the hole and tin the hole. You see, if you look in the hole now, it's a dull colour. I'll put some flux on the ball. Put the ball in the hole. Heat it up and then feed some solder around the rim. And as I heat it up, the ball should bubble underneath, and you see the ball lift up. See the air coming out. And the solder in there. Stop applying the heat. And as it cools down, it should suck that ball into the hole. Let that cool down. The probe finished. Well, these are the finished parts and I'm going to assemble them. I've made a few modifications. So on the plastic part, what I've modified is I've added a 5mm wide by 14mm diameter to give me more plastic around the thread to stabilize the probe a bit better. On the other end, I've added 10mm and bored that out to 8mm for 10mm deep, so the batteries will now fit in the end here, which insulates them from the outside, because if the first battery touched the outside, it would only give you half the voltage. And that means that on the body you just have to take the 10mm bore 10mm deeper to accommodate the extra length. So now we come to the assembly part. The LED I'm using is a 1.5 volt LED. The batteries are button cell batteries, and the number on the battery is 392A, and each one is 1.5 volt. So you might say, well, that's 3 volt you're putting through a 1.5 volt LED. It doesn't seem to give it any problems. In fact, you probably lose some of the voltage as it goes through the machine. So one battery, the LED is not bright enough. Two batteries, it's okay. So the first thing you need to do for the LED is you're never going to get these wires, because they're quite stiff wires, to bend into the body to leave the LED sticking out like that. So what I'm going to do is cut these two wires off and solder some wire on that's a bit more flexible than this. Here's one that I did earlier. I've cut the two wires off on the LED so that would give me a bit more flexibility. And what I want to do first is solder the two brass parts that we made onto the wire. A small one and a longer one. The longer one goes onto the battery holder end, and the short one goes into the back of the 6mm thread we've put in there. So I'll solder these on first. Take the wire, heat it, just run some solder along, push it through the hole in the brass, solder the end, same on the second one, put some solder on. Let them cool down. Just check by pulling the wire that it's a good joint. And if you've got any solder left on the end, just take a small file to flatten the face. Now what I've done is cut the wires and bared the wires so there's enough wire to go from the end to the centre hole on both parts. We can thread the wire through. So it comes out the side hole and just push the brass part home. The same on the other end. To screw the probe in, and that will push the brass home. When you screw the ball probe in, it should come just up to the face. You may need to take some off the end of the thread so that this will screw in and tighten up on the face, not the electrical contact. The next part is to take the LED and solder it to the wires. Just using this little clamp to hold the LED. Solder the wires to the LED, but before you press it into the body, fit the batteries into the holder with the positive end facing the probe. Then connect the wire temporary to the back of the battery to the probe, and the LED should light up. If it doesn't light up, swap the two wires around connecting the LED. It's working okay. You can see there the LED is just lined up with the hole, and the small hole on the back is to be able to poke a stick through there, or a cocktail stick, to push the LED forward. Now if all goes well, you should have the LED in line with the hole. In the probe, what I've done is when I've centre drilled it, I've got room there for a very small spring. So when you screw the probe into the body, it should tighten up on the face. If you've got a gap and it's tightened up, you need to take some off the length of the probe. If it's tightened up but there's no electrical contact, you can put a small spring inside to make up the gap. Now, the easiest way I've found of putting the batteries in is put the batteries on top of your brass end and then just put the probe over the top, push the end cap in and then screw on the cap. And you'll see here it won't go on any further than that. So let's test the battery. All you need to do is get a piece of wire from the probe to the probe body and the LED should light. So that's all working okay. The next thing I need to do is just take about 4mm off the end to let the cap tighten up onto the battery. I've taken 4mm off here to the same diameter and taken 4mm off the end so that when that goes in, the brass part is level with the end. I then found a spring that will just fit over that brass part, it's level. So the brass part will go into the hole, and as you screw this in, that should give you a good contact. And to test it, all you need to do is put the wire between the two. The light works. That's the finished part. If you get any problems with the electric contact not working properly, you can put a stronger spring in so it pushes on the brass parts inside. That's it, so let's go and put it on the milling machine. So what I've done is I've put the dial indicator in the milling machine. And as soon as the dial indicator touches, the light should come on. It's running out about 3 thou, I think. Three and a half thou. I couldn't understand why the probe was running out 4 thou, so I just put a dowel in the chuck, turn the spindle. You can see the chuck is running out 3 and a half thou, so that means my probe is only running out about, that's nearly 4 thou there, so it looks as if my probe is running true and it's a chuck that's running out. So what I'll need to do is get some collets that will hold a 14mm body of the probe so I know that it's running true to the spindle. And of course, if you've got digital readouts on your machine, it makes it a lot easier to work out the centre, because you can feed the offset in of the ball diameter, wind it across. As soon as it touches, the light should light up. So I know that's the edge of my material. The ball is 0.375 inch, which is 9.525 millimetric. So half of the ball is 4.762. So if I lift this up, move the table over 4.762, it's about there. Now that ball now should be, the edge of that material's in the middle, which means that the spindle edge is in the middle. Now, I know it's running out 3 thou, but what you can do is mark the high or the low spot and just rotate the spindle to get the the middle of it so it takes a run out. I think what I need to do is just face the plastic off now I've pressed it in to make sure it's square to the outside. Move it across. Move it back till it touches. Zero. I want to get across to the other side. So that works out to about 20mm, that bore. Well, that's it for today. I hope that was useful. I hope to see you next time on Enots Engineering.